Hi everyone, Anthony Fantano here, the internet's sleepiest music nerd, and it's time for a sleepy little review of the new Autechre LP, Excite. Autechre is an electronic music duo hailing from the UK who for decades have been creating everything from experimental techno to IDM, glitch music, and through the many full-length albums that Sean Booth and Rob Brown have produced together over the years, they have proven themselves to be extremely, extremely creative and explorative personalities when it comes to the world of sound and sound manipulation. And that applies both to percussion, just the timbres, the textures that these guys put together in their beats, along with synthesizers, which typically have a pretty fat analog sound to them when Autechre is putting synth chords, synth melodies together, and the way that these guys manipulate synthesizer sounds, it's really somewhat of a lost art, in my opinion, something that was much more prevalent back in the 90s when a lot of people perceive Autechre to have been having their musical heyday. But what I feel that makes Autechre different than many other artists that are on a similar sonic journey is that their search for sounds, their exploration for sounds, tends to be extremely, extremely methodical. Sort of like a chemist looking for the perfect amount of the right element to create the just right chain reaction for some kind of extremely complicated equation. Now, the sounds and the textures that Autechre works with have evolved over the years, sometimes deciding the overall path of entire full-length albums, especially like a few of their most recent, Choristus and Oversteps, both of which had a much more ambient and experimental feel to them in comparison to some of their more beat-oriented work. These two LPs also combined elements of glitch and IDM, which typically show up in Autechre's music, but no matter how little or how greatly these guys change on a given full length, one thing kind of remains the same and remains constant, and that is the emotional quality of their music. Rarely is Autechre's music very visceral, or visceral in the way that we typically see visceral music. It doesn't get your blood pumping, it doesn't get you thrashing about like a punk song would, or you know, a really hard hip-hop beat would, or a metal song would, or like a dubstep song, or even a traditional techno song. Instead, Autechre shoot for something that is much more cerebral, much more thought-provoking, something that is going to attract extremely analytical listeners like flies to a dead corpse. And those extremely analytical listeners may be very pleased by the challenge that Autechre presents to them on this new LP, which is 2 discs and 2 hours long. I'm sure hardcore fans will completely soak this album up, but Excite is not for your casual or maybe even first-time Autechre listener. Possibly. For the most part, Autechre is sticking to a lot of the same genre confines that people place them into, the glitch, the IDM, the experimental or avant-garde techno, a touch of ambient music too. They constantly look for new and different sounds to engage the listener with on one track after another through this 17 song affair. However, there's not an immense amount of emotional variation throughout this LP. There are some tracks that stand out past others in the fact that they may feel a little bit sweeter through some synthesizer chords. Others, like the opener on here, have a bit of a drum and bass influence, I feel. But the drums that would, you know, typically be in a drum and bass song are replaced with noisy, sharp glitches. And Autechre presents slower moments as well, like the closer on this album, which feels like, to an extent, kind of a synth odyssey. Still, that doesn't stop this LP from kind of feeling like an overnight cram session. And that's because even in its most upbeat and intense moments, XI really only kind of gets my head bobbing moderately. The stimulation that the album brings to me is much more of a inside of my head. My brain just really starts kind of firing off electricity in many different directions because of all the sounds that they hit me with. And the array of sounds that Autechre bring to the table does make this LP pretty ambitious. It's also ambitious from a length perspective, although I think some people could charge this album as not really being that outside the box for Autechre in terms of just the way their music feels. It's still very cold, it's still very kind of scientific. And because of that, it does become sort of difficult to say what is a highlight on this album and what isn't. There are tracks on here like IR Light, which are 10 minutes, a song that Autechre presents right at the second track of this LP. And this song with a handful of others, man, these guys are presenting these 10 or 12 minute monoliths, something that they kind of gravitated away from on some of their more recent releases. And I'm actually happy to see them return to this style because they really know how to develop a track and make it interesting from beginning to end, but still always kind of remaining very abstract and kind of chilly. That's not to say that Autechre's music doesn't have humanity to it. It most definitely does. There are patterns that are pleasing and easy to get into. There are clear chord progressions that do have sort of a logical progression to them. However, there are other tracks on here like Prac F, for example, which when it comes to grooves or patterns or anything like that, feel incredibly irregular. The beat on this track feels like it almost skips a beat in the way it moves. It's this track and maybe a few others like it on here where I feel like I'm hearing maybe 3 to 4 different elements, a beat, maybe a few different synthesizer phrases, and it feels like the only thing they truly have in common is a tempo, and that's about it. And as I listened through to this LP again and again and again, I sort of began to see a little bit more of a pattern between some of these tracks where maybe some of the synthesizer melodies or the beats backing the synthesizers seem a little bit random. I guess another standout on here is the song Tess XI, which to me has kind of a tropical flavor to the synthesizers, sort of reminding me of that Lone album that I dug so much last year. It's really kind of got this Caribbean feel to it, but eventually the track gets kind of dark, sort of murky, submerging itself back into the ocean where it came. Truly where this album finds its magic is in the variety of sounds and flavors and speeds and intensities that it brings to the table. Like I already said, I feel like I'm repeating myself again, but I have to bring this point home, that this is what makes this album appealing. Though, on the whole, it's not anything altogether new for Autechre. It's still coming from that same emotional place where I feel like this album reaches a new, maybe a subtly new and higher level of awesomeness is in just how freaking detailed it is. Because of how cold that this album can feel, some people may sort of tune it out just in general because it doesn't really bring the attitudes or the emotions that people typically look for in music. Anger, happiness, happiness, sadness, love, maybe a little bit of lust. This album has little to none of those things. However, that's not to say that it's not beautiful or inspiring or extremely proficient from a technical standpoint and well produced. Really, it's all of those things. I can't help but stand in awe of just its vastness, of its expansiveness. The amount of electronic nooks and crannies that have been placed throughout this LP can be listened to and observed for months upon months and still not be fully appreciated or understood. And in my opinion, that's actually a pretty fantastic feat. It's like this never-ending puzzle. It brings this constant sense of intrigue to the listener. All of these things add up into what I feel has been one of the more unique experiences I've had with electronic music over the past half a year or so. I'm feeling a decent to strong 8 on this LP. If you've given it a listen, what did you think of it? Did you love it? Did you hate it? Why? What do you think I should review next? And yeah, that's about it. Autechre, XI, forever.